It's been a great honor for me to be associated with Christ for India since its very inception. When I had the privilege of meeting Dr. P.J. Titus in the very early 1980s, what a joy it was to find a kindred heart, a man whose heart beat for his native nation of India, but also for all of the world to come to know Jesus Christ. Dr. Titus and I shared a very wonderful bond and partnership in the gospel until his homegoing a few years ago. And now what a joy it is to see his sons, Jameson and Johnson, as well as his beloved wife, Mary, continue the ministry, all of the Titus family, continuing the ministry that was so nobly begun in his heart. I considered Dr. Titus one of my very dearest friends. I went to him often for his counsel. I knew of no finer missions thinker in all of the world, and I was grateful for the privilege of being on the ground floor of the Ministry of Christ for India and serving for several years on its board.
India is a beautiful country. It's naturally beautiful, forest and palm trees, mountains, hills. The God has created us to enjoy the aesthetics of the creation. And we are part of that beautiful creation in Bhimali, by the beach, just near the beautiful hill. Early morning sun rises over our hills, and we enjoy these terrains of God's pastures. And I want the world to know that India is a beautiful country and beautiful people with beautiful future. And that is the optimism that keeps me going on a positive preaching of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the kingdom that India is building for tomorrow.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not be all else to me, save that thou art. Thou my best thought, by day or by night.
Christ for India exists to fulfill Christ's great commission in the great land of India by training young men and women to become pastors and evangelists, to plant churches in unreached areas, to help alleviate the suffering through humanitarian works for our medical, dental, and eye care ministry, and through educating children in a Christian environment. Almost 900 children this year will be educated in a Christian environment on campus. I want to thank you for your prayers, for your support, that you've helped us in the ministry celebrate this past three decades in ministry in India, reaching many lost souls for Christ.
Can you hear? There's a new song breaking out from the children of freedom. Every race and every nation, sing it out, sing a new hallelujah, yeah.
Let me share with you one of the new visions that we have is the Media Center on campus. The Media Center is designed to be able to train our young men and women to use media to share the gospel.
We'll have two windows from the control room, which is there, and the control room will be able to see everything visually and have the recording part in this room will be one of the recording with all the mics and everything in here, and the control room will be able to see everything that's happening in this side of the room. Two to three sets here where we can have the lighting on the top here. We can have one set here, possibly one set here. We're praying on getting that equipment that we've been set to have some funds aside for. We still need to come back and do the material on the ceiling and top, and we'll still need to do the installing of the lights, and then we'll get all the rest of the equipment. This is going to be one of the best studios in this city by God's grace, and we'll be able to help other ministries, other ministers, our students be able to use this studio to not only share the gospel on and produce programs, but to bless other ministries that will come here and use our studio to generate their programs and specials that they can use on different channels in India for the Indian market and abroad. I'm grateful to God for a great team of young people that we have on campus that are leading in the school, in the seminary, in the printing press, in the hospital. We have a great team that's been assembled, and God's given us the favor of faithful servants in the ministry for many years, and many new ones are being trained and groomed to take over and to lead the ministry.
Hi, my My name is Urmila, and I'm studying in 10th class. I'm 15 years old, and I thank for your valuable prayers, and I thank you for your supporting financially and allow me to stay in this campus. And I'm very thankful to you, and I'm also praying for you every day.
Here's just some of our testimonies of our seminary students. Please take a moment just to watch these great testimonies of these young men and young women.
By looking back to my life, and now I should say that I am completely changed. And now I'm doing my MTF final years, and after this graduation I have a desire, since I was frustrated with the world, and I have a desire to bring those youth by ministering among them, such like teaching and teaching some songs and leading them to the right way.
I met in sitting electric shock. I was about to die, but I was on the bed again. I could not able to move. So from there, I prayed to God to heal my sickness. And I prayed to God and He healed my sickness. And from that year, I took strong decision to study His words, to do His God's ministry.
Next year, I would like to engage in ministry. And my call is to do teaching as well as evangelist ministry. I want to be an evangelist for God. Thank you.
Even though some of the methods have changed, our vision's still the same, to reach the 1.2 billion souls for Christ.
Give me your eyes for just one second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Give me your eyes, Lord, give me your eyes so I can see. For everything that I keep missing. Give me your heart for the brokenhearted.
Vision and dream only goes larger as time goes by because of the grace of God and because of the value of the dream itself. It was a great joy to serve on the board of directors for many years. Our hearts continue to be with you. We know that the greatest days of ministry for Christ for India are just ahead. A legacy has already been left, but now we go into a wonderful future where I believe for the nation of India, and particularly for the Church of India, greater days than ever before are just ahead. Christ for India, God bless you, and we congratulate you on this important milestone.